Space. Almost everyone has an opinion and is intrigued in some way, shape, or form. The topic that I've been assigned, which is the debate over whether we should continue to fund the space program and as it currently exists, is one that is very multi-layered and very difficult to kind of sort through. But it features two very logical opposing arguments that have very good sound reasoning on both sides, but ultimately differ on the value of space exploration and the likelihood of finding anything and making any new impactful discoveries with continued subsidization. Those, on one hand, you have those in favor of space exploration that argue it remains a worthwhile initiative, even in its current state. Some, just like Monica Grady in her article, "Of Course Space Exploration is Worth the Money," from June 10th, 2015, feel that the value of the potential of discovery in space makes the space program something we have to continue to fund and makes it a very advantageous endeavor. A lot of people share this sentiment because of the fact that there's just so much out there that we still don't know, and there's still so many questions that have gone unanswered. Some take a little different, more practical approach, just like Michael Watkins in his article, "Continued Support of Space Exploration is a Must if America is to Succeed," from October 19, 2015. More of an economic perspective, citing how NASA creates thousands and thousands of jobs and stimulates valuable research and development that have made way for dramatic technological advance over the years. And on a more practical level, that's a way, a perspective to look at the issue that really justifies the billions of dollars that we pour into the space program every year. And finally, many others argue that having a functional space program is essential to national defense, just like Elisabetta Antini cites in 10 Reasons We Should Be Exploring Space from June 22, 2015. It can be very important, just like it had been during the space race of the 50s and 60s, to national defense. And that's another very valid argument that side can make. On the other hand, you have those opposed to space exploration who claim that, as it currently exists, the space program is very wasteful with its funds, and it really ultimately hampers the government's ability to allocate resources to other pressing issues. Some on this side, like Jerry DeGroot, who in his article, "The Space Race is a Pointless Waste of Money," from February 25th, 2009, they question NASA's true motives and whether or not, and really argue that their current endeavors in space are just a pointless way to justify its excessive funding. Others feel that just pouring money, just like Peter Roth said in To Infinity and Beyond, More Wasteful Spending in NASA, his article from April 10, 2013, argues that pouring money into the space program that really is not as productive as it used to be really is a burden on the economy, as opposed to the other side that looks at the benefits to the economy. Ultimately, if we put more and more money into a program that isn't producing anything of value year in and year out, that can really take a toll on the economy and just increases and makes the national debt even that much worse and puts us further and further behind as a nation economically. Some others, just like is cited in Jerry DeGroot's article, "The Space Race is a Pointless Waste of Money," from February 25th, 2009, also argue that the space program is really stuck in the nostalgia of the 1960s and doesn't have any real purpose in this day and age. And that, it seems to be, on that side of the argument, a very much increasingly popular opinion. And finally, some will argue that the millions and millions of dollars that we spend every year, just like Keith Yost cites in "Should We Cut NASA's Funding," from his article on April 9th, 2010, the millions and billions of dollars that we put into the space program every year could be have a much bigger and more positive effect if put towards any of the many social issues that we face today, or to help the federal budget and go towards the national debt that's ever growing. As you can tell, there are various lenses that you can look at through on each side, and valid reasoning no matter which side of the discussion that you're looking at. This debate is obviously very multifaceted and very layered in a lot of different ways, and is very much worth discussion and consideration. Thank you.